Hey everyone, it's Tuesday, November 13th. We've had some snow over the last little while, and Kuskanax has got some snow on it, so I decided to get some of my heavier gear out, and I'll show you when I get up to Vicky's View. I just got my Danners on. I got my full crew suit from when I had my EOD days. I'll show you when I get to Vicky's View. But we're just going to see how it is in the warm, with all this gear. I'm not used to walking in boots and stuff, so, because you got to carry those around too, right? But anyway, beautiful day. Kind of like just around freezing, like wet snow. Just a beautiful view up here. I know this kind of the clouds socking in. You can just barely see the mountain there, but beautiful nonetheless. Anyway, heading on up for a little walk, a little workup. Got to keep the heart pumping. You gotta keep it strong. Anyway, we'll see you at the Vicky's View there. Okay, so I made it up to Vicky's View. Another beautiful view from Vicky's View, as per normal. Just a gorgeous day. Just an absolutely gorgeous day. It's hovering around freezing. I thought it was a little colder, and I wanted to try this gear out, but it's not cold enough for this. It's too hot in this gear. I've got my heavy duty military minus 60 degrees Fahrenheit mitts. This is stuff I took to the North Pole with me when I went to alert. But the crew suit from my EOD days in the 90s, I just kept it. It's one of these obsolete pieces of kit that they were going to throw it away, so I kept it. And it's all wool, most of it's wool, but too warm for today. But really good to try and get this gear up the hill, because I got my heavy Danners on. I got my Danner boots. I don't have my Peter Pan getaway slippers on today. Heavy coveralls, heavy jacket. So just to see how heavy boots. It was a work to get up here. It's easy to prance up here in my slippers and shorts when it's 80 degrees and I'm half naked. But once I start loading up the gear, it gets a little harder. But beautiful day, beautiful scenery. I was hoping it would be a little colder, maybe a bit more snow, but I'm just going to keep coming here as the snow piles up. I'm just going to keep coming here, working out. Hopefully it'll get cold enough that I can really take advantage of this. But I wasn't sweating per se, but this is just a little too warm for today. But peace wherever you are. I hope you're having a great day. I hope everything is going well. As we proceed towards the end of the year, I imagine they're going to start ramping up the fear and trying to get us all, hating our neighbor and stuff like that. But strong in your heart, strong in your mind. Push everything else away, you'll be fine. Because they're pulling out all the stops now with the craziness going on. So, but anyway, take care. We'll see you on the next one. Okay, so we're just back at home. Just going to show you the label on the crew suit and what it's made out of. 100% nylon. The inner lining is 100% wool. And the shell, the outer shell is 50-50 cotton and nylon. Very good pant and jacket combination. And here's the glove here, actually, or the mitt, sorry. Leather. It's got a piece of fur right here, so you can wash your nose off. The mitt itself, the inner liner, is 50-50. Like, it's this wool here. This is wool. But then I've got it inside out. Then it's nylon. Right now it's inside out, so the wool would be against your hand, the nylon would be against this, but man oh man, these gloves are wicked warm too. I use them anytime I go skiing, and I've never had cold hands, In the days of having a smoke, you pull your hand out and have a smoke, and you could put your hand back in, and it'd warm up instantaneously, and pull it out, put it back. I've had these gloves have had snow in them and stuff, but jacket's the same as the pant, there's no different. But there again, very old technology, old school, wool, heavy, not new technology where it's lightweight and thin. So very cumbersome, very thick, but I'm one of these guys that if it ain't broke, don't fix it. If this stuff works for me, I'll wear it until it just completely discombobulates on my body, and then, I'll break down and go buy something fancy like my Peter Pan getaway shoes. They're fancy and they're cool and they're light and everything like that, my Five Fingers, but totally impractical when it starts getting cold and stuff like that. So if you can put up with a little bit of weight and cumbersome equipment, you can pick this stuff up probably at an army surplus or something. I was too hot today, that's for sure, but you can just see the quality of the zipper. Look at the zipper on this thing. Just look at that. That's a heavy duty brass zipper. It's not gonna rust. Brass,
brass zipper. You know, all this, these are all brass zippers and stuff. They're not steel or anything. They're not going to rust. Non-mag too. So, you know. So there you go. So you can go in on an EOD. And this is what we did wear for our EOD days. So back in the 90s. I wore this back in 94 when I was in the EOD center in Halifax. So that's 1,000 years ago. But anyway, just wanted to show you what we had on today. Talk to you later.